Several years back during one of our beautiful Arizona springs, I had a bit of a aha reminder moment while walking the ducks from their bunkhouse over to the orchard pond. Once they take a quick swim and eat their breakfast, they tend to circulate all around the orchard throughout the day, eating new weed growth and bugs. And I do a roll call, coming and going, to count the ducks, because we have predators at night, and we risk losing a duck if they're left behind. And this particular evening, I was short one, so I did my due diligence. I poked around the pond, under the peach and apricot trees, along the fence line, and eventually I found Larry, one of our first ducks that we raised from a duckling, hiding in the rosemary. Normally all the ducks lay their eggs in the bunkhouse and then head out for the day, but she was sitting on eggs in one of the shrubs, and had to kind of fish her out. It immediately reminded me of Easter egg hunting as a child, and a lesson that I'd learned from a local farmer and neighbor. She explained to me that this ritual of searching for eggs was not random, although to most modern folk it seems to be just that, a random non sequitur ritual. She said that the reason for most people's opinion on this matter is because every grocery store everywhere has eggs available year-round. 6-packs, 12-packs, 18-packs, every color, every shape. And, you know, because they are so readily and abundantly available year-round, we forget the struggles of a time period when they were not. There was a time when egg-laying was directly associated with spring and new growth and rebirth and survival and the perpetuation of all creatures who had survived the long winter. Of course, the perpetuation of these ducks relied on their eggs not being found by other winter survivors, obviously, so they would cleverly hide them in from the predators. It was a fairly simple story of to be or not to be in basic survival, and one which, in my opinion, we have lost touch with. In a way, Easter egg hunt is a cognitive and situational awareness survival training for our kids, as well as serving as muscle memory for times when we might need it most. Eggs are the last item in your refrigerator to go bad, and this has everything to do with their shape and the absence of corners, that idea, that metaphor of infinity and regeneration. Thermal density and the interplay between subtle, almost imperceptible heat and cold enjoy uninterrupted, random movement inside that infinite surface of the egg, so kind of a survival of its own, and an appropriate symbol for the vernal equinox and the new light that it brings, resulting in everything springing to life. Keep in mind, this period of time arrives on the heels of a long period of darkness. If a family had a difficult growing season that affected the harvest from the previous autumn or the fall equinox, surviving the long night could prove difficult, and on the shortest and darkest day of the year, at the end of December, known as the winter solstice, family, friends, neighbors, they bring each other gifts to ensure they make it through. These were gifts of hope, and in some cases, literal salvation. As romantic a notion as it is, we are not islands, and we cannot always do this thing called life on our own. The cliche, "it takes a village to raise a child," also applies to maintaining a healthy village.
Take a
there's a breathtaking celestial event that serves as a perfect metaphor for this healthy community ideology known as the Paschal Moon. This is the full moon following the spring equinox when it lands in April. It's called the Egg Moon, not coincidentally. If one has a clear view of opposite horizons, there's an incredible moment that can occur just at sunrise when the Egg Moon is visible. For a brief moment, the moon appears to be as bright as the sun, and they seem identical. Using the cycle of the moon as a metaphor for the lifetime of a person, and the waxing thin sliver of light as their awakening consciousness, and the formation of self, and the waning light as our elder years. Then the full moon represents that fully developed self, the full light of our accomplishments and personality shining for all to see. But in reality, this is not the person's or the moon's light at all. It's the infinite light from a higher power, the sun. And we are simply reflecting that light, which in the instance of spring, is the bringer of life, rebirth, reproduction, resurrection, reconnection, of salvation, of infinity, and of hope. Have a happy Easter.